You will get the most from any Systems to Win video when you launch it from its video homepage.
We're assuming that you already know why lean process improvement is so popular and so effective, and why Systems to Win templates are so helpful. And most importantly, why do you care? If you have a big enough why, you'll figure out how. So in this video, we're assuming that you're ready to get down to business and start getting some things done. And the very first question you're going to have is, where are my templates? How do I find and open my templates? There are actually five different ways to find and open your templates, but most users only need to know two of them, and that's what we're going to focus on in this training video. When you have the Systems to Win add-in installed, you'll see the Systems to Win tab up here. Let's select it. Let's select this button called Systems to Win Templates. That opens a window where you can scroll to view and open any of your 150 plus Systems to Win templates. Or if you have the trial version, the couple dozen trial and shareware templates. Let's select this analysis template, which will open a standalone Excel workbook. And each workbook will consist of multiple worksheets. So it will always open to the help sheet that contains help for how to use any template. And then the sample sheet will show you some helpful sample data of what a finished document might look like. But you don't do your real work on the sample sheet. When you're ready, you click the Systems to Win tab. And then when you click the button to open a blank sheet, notice that where there had been three sheets, now there's four. And that's the sheet where you will do your real work. Another thing to notice, when you select the Systems to Win Templates button in Excel, is that all of your Systems to Win templates are available through Excel, including your Word templates, PowerPoint, PDF templates, not just Excel templates. So you actually open a Word template through Excel. So let's open up this A3 report, and that will launch Microsoft Word. Now it's rare, but if you ever get an error when you do that, then the fix is to open Word in the background first, and then come back into Excel and do this exact same thing, and everything will work just fine. Now, if your A3 report opens up and it does not look like this, then that is because the view settings in your computer, maybe you have web layout selected rather than the preferred print layout. Or maybe your Word is set up to display just one page instead of multiple pages. And you can control click this link to open a training page that has more tips for how to get the most from your Word templates. But that's the subject for another video. The key point of this video is that if you know the name of your Systems to Win template, then the way you open it up is through the Systems to Win Templates menu in Excel. And if you're in a hurry, that's all that you really need to know for now. Go ahead, open up your template and get going. If you're not in a hurry, then you're going to greatly benefit from what we're going to learn next. The second way to find and open your Systems to Win templates is to use your tool selection matrix. And that's what we'll learn next. First, let's open our tool selection matrix the same way that you open any Systems to Win template. Then if your list is sorted by name, which like most Windows programs you can do by clicking the header at the top of a column, then your tool selection matrix will appear at the very top of the list. We actually renamed the tool selection and the training matrix to start with the number one specifically so that they would be at the top of the list because they are so important to the success of your continuous improvement efforts. And like every Systems to Win Excel template, it opens up to a help worksheet, which is always organized the exact same way, so that when you know how to find help for any Systems to Win template, you know how to find help for every Systems to Win template. Unlike most Systems to Win Excel templates, you won't use the button to open a blank sheet. If you do click that button, then a dialog will come up telling you that you don't need to. For this particular tool, you can simply open the template tab, which opens a sheet that has one row for each of your 150 plus Systems to Win templates. And like every Systems to Win template, if you click any row or column header, you will get pop-up help, providing tips and guidance for the many ways that you can filter this list to come up with a short list of tools that might be worth considering for whatever it is that you need to do next. And we'll come back to that in just a moment, but for right now, let's point out that like every Systems to Win template, you can also click this link to go to the web page that has online training and this training video for how to use this tool. And then back on your Excel template, in addition to the pop-up help for each header column, notice that in this row, there are also links that you can click to open online training pages for any lean methods that you want to learn more about. And if we scroll over, we see that this column contains similar help and training for each of your 150 plus tools. So your tool selection matrix is a very useful information center to not only quickly find the right tool, but also find useful help and training for whatever it is that you need to do next. But what if you are a global organization with team members that don't speak English so good? Are they going to have the help and training they need to get off to a good start using your standardized tools, training, and systems? In the upper right corner of every page on the Systems to Win website, you can teach your international users to click this link that opens a training page that has a video and written instructions for how to translate every one of our training web pages, closed captions for each of our training videos, and if your company purchased language translations for your templates, then that training page and video teach you how to use your translations and substitutions button to select your desired translation for any of your Systems to Win Excel templates, which will make your tools, training, and systems so much more useful for all of your team members. Now notice that there's one column that is not translated. What is that column and why isn't it translated? So back on the English version, we noticed that the title and purpose columns were translated, but this column was not. And the title of that column is also known as. If we click the pop-up help for that column, we see that it has a couple of tips. One of those tips is that we can use Control F to find key phrases. So let's do it. Let's press the Control and the F key together, which brings up this dialog window where we can enter a word or phrase to search for. Maybe we're looking for a spaghetti diagram. And when we click the Find Next button, it found our word in row 77. And the second tip, found in both the pop-up help and right there in the header itself, is that we can resize columns to view long text. So if we use what we know about Excel to drag the width of the column, we can see that if we had been searching for the term standard work diagram, we might have had to widen the column just to be able to see what Control F found. And just to save space, we can make that column narrow again. In the title column, we see that Systems to Win calls that a layout diagram, which also happens to be the file name. So now we know the name of the file that we're looking for. If we open the template the usual way that we learned earlier in this video, but our tool selection matrix gives us an even easier way to just select this link to open the template. Click Yes to Microsoft's Hyper Nanny security warning, and that opens that template to the help page, which is organized the exact same way for every Systems to Win template. And most templates have a sample page that shows a sample of what a finished document might look like, but you know better than to do your real work on the sample page. When you're ready, you click the Systems to Win menu and open a blank sheet that you then maybe rename, and that's where you do your real work. Now, as the name suggests, the primary purpose of a tool selection matrix is to select the right tools. So let's start by scrolling a bit. So let's say that we're in the healthcare industry, or more commonly, that we're working on a process that is for office or administrative or service. So we select the filter arrow for that heading, and we uncheck the Select All checkbox, and then we select what we want to filter for. In this case, a heart filters for tools that are really popular for office and service, and an X means it's somewhat popular, and we want them both. And now the list has been filtered to show only those tools that are good for an office or service environment. And if we zoom in, we can barely see that that little filter drop-down arrow now shows a tiny little picture of a filter, which indicates that that column is being used for filtering. And we can have multiple filters. So let's say that we're looking for tools that are good for process flow in a service office environment. We again uncheck the Select All checkbox, select what we do want, and that narrows down our choices. And then we might filter even further for where are we in the PDCA cycle, or whatever. If you still only have the trial version, then you might use this column to show only the trial and or free templates that come with the trial version. But notice that the trial templates include a disproportionate number of tools that require a high skill level. So you might decide to try them all, including the easy ones, with a money-back guarantee. To turn any filter off, you can simply check the Select All box. Or, an easier way to clear all of your filters at once is to select the More section of your Systems to Win menu, Set or Reset Filter. So in this training video, we've shown you how to find and open your Systems to Win templates as their own standalone workbook. Right next to that button, there's another button called Insert Sheet. And you can use that button to insert special purpose process improvement sheets into any Excel workbook. Maybe insert a sheet or two for leading a team, or to improve a process, or insert a sheet to train your people on how to do things the new way. You know how to search the Systems to Win site to find related training and videos to make your process improvement skills better. In summary, have you ever noticed that when you give a child a hammer, suddenly everything needs hammering? Similarly, if you only teach your people how to use 5 or 6 tools, is it any surprise that sometimes they aren't using the right tool for what they need to do next? At Systems to Win, our mission is to help you to continuously improve your tools and systems for continuous process improvement.